Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. I am very happy to share with you these facts on Moschops. Moschops was a therapsid that lived in the Guadalupian epoch around 265 to 260 million years ago. They were heavily built, massive plant eaters, and they may have lived partly in water like hippopotamuses. They had short, thick heads and might have competed by headbutting each other. Their elbow joints allowed them to walk with a more mammal-like gait rather than crawling. Numerous chisel-edged teeth, suitable for cropping vegetation, were present in the jaws. The animal's back characteristically sloped downward from the front to the back in a giraffe-like fashion. The limb girdles or supports were massive, especially in the shoulder region, and the bone on the top of the skull was greatly thickened. Their remains were found in the Karoo region of South Africa, belonging to the Tapinocephalus Assemblage Zone. Therapsids, like Moschops, are synapsids, the dominant land animals in the Permian period, which ended 252 million years ago. Moschops is a rare example of one of the few early mammal-like reptiles that the general public is actually aware of. In part, this is due to its inclusion in most books about ancient animals, although few people may actually remember watching the kids' TV series Moschops from the early 1980s. Moschops were heavily set dinocephalan synapsids, and at 8.9 feet or 2.7 meters long, it was one of the largest herbivores of its day, with Johncaria being the only potential size rival, at around 10 feet or 3 meters long, with some specimens reaching up to 16.4 feet or 5 meters long. Nonetheless, it isn't this large size that was the source of Moschops' fame, but its skull. The upper bone in the skull of Moschops was roughly 4 inches or 10 centimeters thick, which means it was thicker than any other of the known animals of its day. One theory for this skull thickness is that Moschops took part in headbutting dominance contests. This doesn't mean that Moschops charged the one another. They most likely just walked up to face one another and then pushed with their heads. Further support for this theory comes from the overall morphology of the Moschops skeleton. The four legs of Moschops carried the body higher than the rear limbs, resulting in a sloping back. This would mean that a large proportion of the body mass was carried on the four quarters and reinforced by the rear. This build probably means that dominance contests in Moschops were about projecting body weight forwards, possibly like sumo wrestlers do today in their matches. However, this build also means that Moschops wasn't a runner and couldn't rely upon either speed or agility to escape predators. Nonetheless, a fully grown Moschops would have been nearly twice as big as most of the known South African predators of the mid-Permian, with the exceptions being Adiosaurus and possibly Johncaria. Possibly only the sick, injured, or juvenile Moschops that wasn't fully grown had reason to fear predators. Additionally, the idea of dominance displays in Moschops also suggests social interaction between individuals. As such, Moschops may have moved in small groups or even herds, with the dominance contest being for mating rights within the herd. They had small heads with broad orbits and heavily built short necks. Like other members of Tapinocephalidae, the skull had a small opening for the pineal organ. The occiput was broad and deep, but the skull was more narrow in the dorsal border. Furthermore, the pterygoid arches and the angular region of the jaw is packed with heavily built jaw muscles. Due to that and the possession of long-crowned, stout teeth, it is thought that Moschops was a herbivore, feeding on nutrient-poor and tough vegetation, like cycad stems. Due to the presumably nutrient-poor food, it is likely they had to feed for long periods of time. The anatomy of the taxa allowed them to open the elbow joints more widely, enabling them to move in a more mammal-like posture than some other animals at the time. This helped to carry their massive bodies more easily while feeding, as well as allowing them to have short bursts of speed. It has also been proposed that Moschops was possibly subaquatic. Moschops are rather thick skulls, prompting speculation that individuals could have competed with one another by headbutting. A 2017 published study would later confirm this by a synchrotron scanning a Moschops capensis skull, which revealed numerous anatomical adaptations to the central nervous system for combative behavior. They were likely preyed upon by titanosuchids and large therapsid species. Moschops material was discovered for the first time by Robert Broom and the Eka group, which is part of the Karoo supergroup, in South Africa. Because the geological horizon was dubious, it was referred to that group on the basis of Parasaurus remains in near proximity. The material includes a holotype, AMNH5550, and 7 topotypes, AMNH551 through 7. The degree of pachyostosis varies within the skulls of the specimens. According to Broom, it is because of gender and age variation within the discovered specimens. In 1910, the material was sent to the American Museum of Natural History in New York City, and it was described in 1911. Moschops means calf face. It was named by Robert Broom in 1911. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Chordata, the clade Therapsida, the suborder Dinocephalia, the family Tapinocephalidae, the subtribe Moschopina, the genus Moschops, and the type species Moschops capensis. Moschops is characterized by a strongly pachyostosed skull with a broad intertemporal region and greatly reduced temporal fossae. Two species are known from the fossil record, Moschops capensis and Moschops cupensis. Two other species were assigned, Moschops waitzi and Owenii, yet their validity is considered possibly dubious. Delphinognathus conocephalus could represent juvenile Moschops, thus possibly synonymous. Delphinognathus is only known from a single, moderately pachyostosed skull. It has a conical boss on the parietal surrounding the pineal foramen. Synonyms are numerous, including Agnosaurus, Abinantia, Delphinognathus, Moschognathus, Moschoides, and Nigalion. While there are a few dubious species, two species are currently recognized, the type species Moschops capensis, and a second species Moschops cupensis. It was a herbivore. It was approximately 8.9 feet or 2.7 meters long. It has been discovered in Karoo, South Africa. It lived in terrestrial environments. It lived during the Guadalupian epoch, specifically during the Wardian Capitanian of the Permian, around 265 to 260 million years ago. And fossil representation includes several specimens. And with that, thank you so much for watching. I will soon be posting some really cool stuff in the YouTube community tab, so stay tuned. As always, thank you for watching. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.